So spirulina is a type of algae, it's a cyanobacteria. And the reason we're growing it, it's because it's an excellent food source. It has especially a high nutritional profile when it comes to iron, vitamin Bs, and it's an excellent source of essential amino acid. Through my research at Maths University, I've done a lot of modeling on productivity, and New Zealand always comes as a very good location for growing algae. And it's not very surprising because growing algae, it's a bit like growing grass. And New Zealand, as we know, is a very good country for growing grass. So you've got the right balance between sun and water. Nice environment, it's not too hot, which is important. Good sun and good quality water. The cultivation in spirulina is very environmentally sustainable for many reasons. So as you can see, it's grown in a pond that's lined. That means we feed the spirulina exactly what it needs, and there's no leaching of nitrogen and phosphorus in the groundwater and surface water. The reason also we're using a greenhouse here is to prevent contamination, obviously, but another reason it prevents evaporation. So we are very efficient when it comes to water usage. Another very interesting thing about growing an algae in a pond like that is that it doesn't really matter what's underneath. So we can grow it on very low productive sandy soil, or as long as we've got a bit of sun, we're fine. The first year, you know, we were virtually standing on sand and grass here. And within a year, we had a product on the market and we had a brand. And that, the speed of that, I think, was really quite an achievement and really good consumer feedback. The second achievement, I think, was in the second year, where we consolidated everything. And we're very thankful to the SFF Future grants for this, because that's really enabled us to diversify our products, but also really improve all our processes here, from the cultivation to the harvesting and all the way to the drying stage. We've been able to improve every single step. For us, spirulina is a first step, and we picked spirulina because it's the low-hanging fruits. There's already an established market and it's relatively easy to produce. So in the short term, what we need to do now is to broaden our range of products and start to export, because we really want to be an export-driven industry that generates profits for New Zealand. But looking much further in the future, we're also really interested in growing other things, not only spirulina, and probably even growing, you know, algae that are very specific to New Zealand and could be food, but could be cosmetic, pharmaceuticals. It's really a huge amount of possibilities out there. The other very important dream is to be able to work together with traditional farming sector, because we see ourselves as very complementary. We don't see any opposition as plant-based versus animal. For us, it's just about working together.